Hello, if you are just joining us, my name is Victoria and I'm with the Geographic Resources Division in the Intermountain Region of the National Park Service. This is the fourth video in a 5-video series focusing on the essential GIS skills selections. This video will cover select by location. Here are our standard disclaimers that were read in the introduction video. And this is where we currently are on our journey through the skill of selections. We are starting now in ArcGIS Desktop version 10.2 session. There are many times when a question comes up that is related to where things are on Earth in relationship to each other. There are numerous combinations of these types of questions, and this video will give a high-level introduction to some of this functionality. Example questions include, how many trails have been in a fire area? What kind of trail segments are within 1 mile of the visitor center? Each feature in the target layer is evaluated against the features in the source layer by the specified selection method. If the specified relationship is met, the target feature is selected and highlighted. The source layer is the data layer that you are doing the selection based on, so it is the source of the location, in this case, fire history. The target layer is the layer that the information will be selected from. It is where the action will be targeted at, in this case, trails. In this exercise, the trails, or target layer, will be selected that are within or intersecting with a fire area, as determined by the park's fire history layer. So let's get started by first clearing the selected features in our window. Let's clear the selected features using the button on the toolbar. In the main menu, left-click Selection, then select by location. In the Select by Location dialog box, confirm that the selection method is Select Features From. You can use the drop-down menu. Check the box to select the target layer. In this example, we're using trails. If you'd like to simplify your target layers, you can also check the box for only show selectable layers in this list. Use the drop-down menu under source layer to select fire history. Using the drop-down menu under spatial selection method for target layer features, confirm that intersect the source layer feature is selected. Make sure that apply a search distance is unchecked. If you would like to continue trying different selections, you can click the apply button to keep the dialog box open. We will be clicking the OK button, which both applies and closes the dialog box at the same time. In the table of contents, we will right-click the trails layer, highlight selection, and zoom to selected features. The map extent will now zoom to show the results of the selection, highlighting the features that are selected in that teal or default color. In the table of contents, right-click the trails layer and open the attribute table. You can see here that 54 out of 290 trails are selected. At this point, we will close out of the attribute table, clear all selected features using the button. We are going to turn off the fire history by unchecking the box in the table of contents. As we move into this next exercise, we will be setting and resetting which layer is the only selectable layer. A commonly asked question when learning selections is, why did ArcMap select so many different features from all the different map layers in my ArcMap? Usually there are many selectable map layers. This can get confusing, so ArcMap lets you limit which layers are selectable. This video tries to show the simpler options first. In video 5, working with selections, it will show more advanced methods. By utilizing different tools and features of ArcMap, you can figure out a workflow that meets your needs. In this exercise, we'll be doing a selection by location with a selected target layer and using a buffer. First, we are going to pan our extent to include the west area of this park. In the table of contents, right-click on the visitor center layer, and under selection, make this the only selectable layer. Using the Select Features tool, draw a box and manually select the visitor center. Right-click on the Trails layer in the table of contents, and under Selection, make this the only selectable layer. Now that we have selected a visitor center and made the trails the only selectable layer, go to Selection, Select by Location. We are going to make sure our selection method is Select Features From. We'll check the box next to our target layer of trails. Down here for the source layer, we are going to change our source layer from Fire History to Visitor Center. Note that one feature is selected, so we are going to check the box to use that selected feature. Confirm that Intersect the Source Layer feature is our spatial selection method for target layer features. Next, we are going to check the box to apply a search distance. We are going to use the drop-down menu to select miles as our units. We will change the amount to equal 1 mile. I'm going to click the OK button to both apply and close the Select by Locations dialog box. We then are going to go to the main menu, go to Selection, Zoom to Selected Features. Next, we will right-click on the Trails layer and open the attribute table. We can see here that 5 out of 290 trails are selected. Of those 5, we have foot and horse and multi-use categories. So we have been able to answer our question as to what types of trail use are available within 1 mile of the visitor center without creating any new data sets or changing any data, just using our selection by location with a selected target layer and buffer. Thank you for watching the Select by Location video.